This is a press conference held today, 29th June 2020, by the League of Nigerian Youth Groups in Abuja here today. We are here today as concerned Nigerian youth leaders to make our position known as regards some critical issues as it affects Nigeria and the way forward. Firstly, there are rumored notices that another lockdown may be announced by the federal government following the increase of COVID-19 outbreaks and cases. We want to advise the Presidential Task Force not to go via the option of advising Mr. President to order for another lockdown, because we can't move forward and begin to move backwards again. Strategic implementation of policies of the Presidential Task Force on COVID-19, how to strengthen what they have put in place, ensuring strict compliance to safety measures and non-pharmaceutical interventions that have been put in place should be the way to go now, not a lockdown. We have gotten to the state where every Nigerian must take responsibility and take ownership of how to navigate the pandemic to stay alive and survive it, while the government ensures that the wearing of face masks, use of sanitizers, physical distancing are enforced strictly. Engaging community and religious leaders and all forms of informal leadership to cede the ownership of fighting the virus to the people. We also advise that the ban on intrastate travels, operation of local flights be lifted and schools be reopened. The second area we want to lend our voice is on the issue of insecurity in Nigeria. We urge us all to encourage our security agents. Unarguably, there have been recorded cases of attacks by terrorists and insurgents. The armed forces are busy daily laying down their lives to keep us and our country safe. Having made diligent investigation as concerned Nigerian youths, we warn leaders of the opposition who are against the federal government leadership, fueling crisis by sponsoring bandits and insurgents to destabilize our country to stop forthwith. We condemn the action of those who frustrate the efforts of our security agencies by leaking out information. We will no longer tolerate attempts by selfish persons to overthrow government in any guise. We propose that the federal government gives special hazard allowances to frontline soldiers, same way our frontline health workers are being provided for during this COVID-19 outbreak, to further boost their morale. There should be increased manpower injected into our armed forces. Fighting equipment is key, and we suggest that the government sets up an armed forces trust fund, same just like the police trust fund, to help fund more equipment to aid the military. It is our candid opinion that if these bases are not met, the situation will remain the same even if new service chiefs are introduced. So first things first. Security is a joint responsibility and not to be left to government alone. The third issue we have decided to speak on is one malpractice we will no longer tolerate: the way some Nigerian youth leaders insult consistent authorities. That is the periodic assault and use of hate speeches on Mr. President, President Muhammadu Buhari, my president, our president, the president and commander-in-chief of the Armed Forces of the Republic of Nigeria. We condemn in totality the rascality and incivility of one of our youths named Ikenga Imo Gochinyere, who is being sponsored by selfish Nigerian leaders opposed to the current leadership of the Federal Republic of Nigeria to periodically sustain the act of abusing and insulting the President of Nigeria, Muhammadu Buhari. We condemn his incisive words of calling on Nigerian youth to forcefully chase the present government out of power. We reject and condemn and demand immediate apology from him in describing Nigeria as a woman. This is an insult to our sensibility as a country and also our Nigerian women, who by this expression, by his own expression, have described them as weaklings. His attack on Mr. President is one too many and should be condemned by every right-thinking Nigerian. We give him 2 weeks to withdraw all personal attacks and insults meted on Mr. President. Youth unionism should not be turned into rascality. Enough is enough. His attitude gives credence to the earlier claim by some groups that he is a paid agent to cause chaos and integration in our country, Nigeria. We and other great Nigerian leaders, youth leaders, decided to pull out of his programs and press conferences, having realized that his aim is always to generate tension, abuse elders and statesmen, and call for youth to join in destabilizing the polity and the government of the day. We urge all Nigerian youth to distance from this approach and urge every right-thinking group not to buy into his ugly agenda. We support constructive criticism, but not destabilization of our dear country, Nigeria. Thanks. And this communique is being signed by Honorable Gosa Chukwubike Samuel, the young national speaker, he is me. Honorable Mubarak Sadiq Ahmed, the president of the Arewa Youth Congress, who is here. Right Honorable Mubarak Aliyu Rimi, the national speaker of Nigerian Students' Parliament, who is here. Negema, the national coordinator of the Southeast Youth Vanguard, who is by my side here. Comrade Salma Musa, the leader of the Council of Northern Female Comrades. Thank you very much, and God bless you.